Our sessions are going to start very shortly. As mentioned, Aries 2021 is designed to cover four main segments. We'll begin with data landscape. We'll listen first to our Aries chairperson, Stephen Ohm, value management specialist and sustainability advocate, and managing director of Quantum Thailand Limited. The chairperson's keynote will discuss unleashing the power of data science in real estate and how we can use data as a tool to help us achieve our sustainability goals.
Welcome to Property Guru Asia Real Estate Summit 2021. My name is Stephen Ohm, and I'm pleased to be the chairman of the summit. Right now, there are over 1,000 delegates in attendance to the summit from the Asia-Pacific region and beyond. The breadth and scope of the Property Guru audience is demonstrated by the nearly 300,000 people that are following the Property Guru Awards on Facebook. The diversity of opinion and diversity of voices for the Asia Real Estate Summit are cherished by us and are reflected in the 32 speakers and panelists in the summit today. The focus of the summit this year is the data revolution and sustainability. The world of data has been unleashed. It takes so many forms. Data and all the technologies that capture, expand, facilitate data's transformation into information is changing our world. This is already happening. There's no going backwards, but where will all this take us? This is an open question. Data is the tool required to achieve sustainability across all four pillars: the environmental, human, social, and the economic. The transformative power of data and technologies is reflected, for example, by social media. YouTube emerged in 2005. In the 16 years that have elapsed since then, it has changed us: how we educate and learn, how we are informed, how we interact, and so much more. In so many ways, YouTube has been incredibly positive. But perhaps that cannot be said of all social media and other data tools that attempt to change us, to consume our time. Data is a tool. It needs a focused purpose, it needs direction, and it needs governance. Sustainability is the path for absolute positivity and progress. It makes good business sense in all respects. Sustainability is the path that so many of us are gladly dedicated to. However, dedication, passion, and vision are not enough. The only measure of real success are outcomes. Without outcomes, we are left with nothing. Or in reality, we are left with a lot worse than nothing. And time goes on. And time is running out. Carbon emissions and CO2 levels are a direct measure to climate change concerns. These measures are also an indirect measure of so much else, from the levels of pollution, inefficiency, waste, and so much more that needs to be addressed to achieve a sustainable future. Last year, at RS 2020, we highlighted the constant rise in CO2 emissions since the Intergovernmental Panel for Climate Change was formed in 1988. Even with all the attention and focus on CO2, in every decade, the CO2 levels have constantly and steadily risen. With the COVID-19 pandemic, it was expected that with all the business disruption, the economic slowdown, the population's lockdown and travelling slowed or stopped, that there might be one benefit, that CO2 emissions would reduce. This has not happened. The global CO2 levels have kept increasing. This chart from the NASA website shows the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration readings of CO2 levels since 2005 through to Q4 2022. There have effectively been no interruption to CO2 levels. This shows how entrenched carbon emissions are in our lives internationally. Even the global pandemic did not have an impact. With focus, tremendous outcomes are possible. If organizations resolve to make step-by-step improvements each and every year, then outstanding results will be achieved. The recent conference of the parties, COP26 in Glasgow, concluded in November this year. This did achieve some outcomes and broadened the focus for environmental sustainability in a number of areas. But on this long-standing issue of carbon emissions, the outcome was for all parties to further consider increasing their commitments and meet a year later at COP27 in November 2022. It is certain that these meetings are making progress, but timing, scope, and surety are issues. As reported here by the BBC, delegates from the fossil fuel companies outnumbered the representatives from many individual countries. It could be considered excellent that the fossil fuel industry are at the table and are pledging significant action. Conversely, people are concerned that the reduction of carbon emissions will continue to be delayed. 62% of anthropogenic CO2 emissions, the emissions caused by man, come from fossil fuels, mostly coal and gas. The promises, pledges, and intentions to achieve carbon neutrality by 2050 need to be considered. To achieve this in 28 years, we would have to all but stop electricity production from coal and gas, and so much else on the energy supply side of the equation. But realistically, this might not happen. So what can and what should we do? With 40% of the world's overall carbon emissions coming from real estate, our sector can make a considerable difference. For example, on the demand side of carbon emissions, we are the consumers, and the outcomes and reductions required are in our hands. With concerted focus, organisations in our sector could determine that they will reduce energy consumption and that their carbon emissions will incrementally reduce step by step every year. Initially, with the lowest hanging fruit, it's always possible to achieve significant reductions. If leaders in the real estate sector adopted an approach of taking small steps, for example, taking a baseline level of 2021 energy consumption and became determined to save on average not less than 3.5% of that baseline every year, that could achieve zero carbon consumption by 2050. This is an example for energy consumption, but this approach is applicable to every sustainability parameter. Pledges for the years in the future, for example, for 2030, for 2050 and beyond, are excellent, but they are not assured. Progress, step by step, each year is assured, and it has so many other benefits. With a strategic and incremental plan, the organisational culture and collective purpose that will be generated within organisations, it may not even take until 2050 to achieve ultimate outcomes. The financial rewards of reducing energy consumption and decarbonisation can be highly significant. For example, it is absolutely clear that energy costs, the cost per kilowatt hour, will increase substantially. Hence, energy cost savings made now will keep increasing in value year on year. The financial risks of small and progressive year-on-year sustainability actions is nil. The rewards for recognition of achievements, positive staff and customer responses are not only valuable, they are becoming more and more essential. If organisations are doing things the same or very similar to how things were done 20 or even 10 years ago, it is certain that very beneficial opportunities and outcomes are being missed. Appropriate cost savings are not being realised, and the organisation's value, real estate values, etc., are being reduced. Some organisations have adopted a wait-and-see approach. Others are making generalised commitments for dates many years from now. These strategies are not in their or anyone's best interests. When yearly sustainability targets can be set so small, but with progress made each and every year, the overall outcomes can be very significant. There's only one path to take, and that is the path of strategic, data-driven annual sustainability plans and incremental actions every year. Unleashing the power of data is most effectively done and can only achieve desired outcomes with a comprehensive plan. However, most organisations do not currently have these. Organisations need to start new and valuable processes through benchmarking, determining key performance indicators, and approaching all aspects of the four pillars of sustainability like every other important business activity. During the course of the summit today, we will hear from our speakers and panellists about the pathways to doing this, the access to green financing, the momentum and expectations of stock exchanges for ESG, with the greater use of data through the lens of sustainability and ESG, it is not a surprise that organisations adopting these approaches are being more successful and are more valuable businesses. In our sector, the scope for achieving sustainability outcomes is vast and compelling. In addition to reducing the real estate footprint environmentally, the importance of creating places achieving improved health and well-being, creating an enhanced indoor environment, and all aspects of human and social sustainability pillars are critically important. The progress of sustainability needs to occur for existing buildings. This should be done under a step-by-step approach as part of the facilities management programs. As per the example of an annual 3.5% reduction in energy consumption, this is achievable and it's very beneficial. This means that every real estate asset and every company can and should be engaged in sustainability action now. Not to only target to achieve results by 2030 or 2050, but to start achieving results in 2022 and 2023. Advancing sustainability to greater levels is of course easier through major capital renewal, real estate refurbishment, and on new projects. But this does not mean this occurs. Even in new projects in many places around the world, sustainability is not being comprehensively and holistically considered. And sometimes sustainability is not properly considered at all. With so many opportunities and rewards for businesses and a clear consensus on major issues, what is holding sustainability back? Perhaps the biggest factor is that sustainability is perceived to cost more. However, this is not correct. Sustainability initiatives can increase capital costs and over time be returned through operational savings. Often, sustainability actually reduces upfront capital costs. What is required are holistic reviews on all aspects of sustainability, and this invariably reduces some costs. Sometimes it can reduce costs very substantially. This is perhaps the biggest obstacle and the biggest myth. To achieve greater sustainability does not have to cost more. Very unfortunately, sustainability is often promoted as a cost that needs to be incurred. That is not right. Sustainability must always make financial sense. It must have a positive financial outcome. Otherwise, businesses cannot make changes and cannot commit to the long-term strategies and outcomes that are required. In any event, we find time and time again, the greater sustainability outcomes actually save upfront costs and also save ongoing costs. So it's not a choice between making profits or being more sustainable. Through holistic reviews and strategic, data-driven plans, the outcomes are being more sustainable and being more profitable. This really is a key message. Another issue that is holding back sustainability is greenwashing. A lot of the feedback we received from RS 2020 was very strongly supporting our calling out of greenwashing as a significant issue. Greenwashing is where data is presented as information that is incomplete, misleading, or just incorrect. Greenwashing has been widely practiced. Often a perpetrator of greenwash really believes in what they're promoting because they believe in their mission and their teams. With the explosion of data, benchmarking, and comparative reviews, the ability for greenwashing to be successful is diminishing very quickly. In fact, greenwashing is becoming a serious liability for organizations, and concerted efforts are required to eliminate greenwash so that truly green products and services are developed and marketed. The COVID pandemic has substantially affected everyone and accelerated change. Every facet of our lives and industry will transform. The way and place that people work has already shifted. This has changed the demand for office space globally, not only in terms of volume of space, but also in terms of purpose, function, and amenity. Significant change is occurring in retail with even higher rates of online shopping that occurred during the pandemic. Retail too will change in terms of purpose, function, and amenity. And so it goes on through every aspect and category of the real estate sector. These new challenges are opportunities. Data is the tool, and sustainability is an important perspective through which to view, analyze, and formulate the most successful outcomes. Is there an upcoming data revolution? Some may think that this is something that has already substantially occurred, but this is not correct. The transformation of data into clear, usable, transparent, and actionable information is only now just emerging. Sustainability is the lens to achieve the outcomes we all desire and the legacy we want to leave. It is an honor to be working internationally in the real estate industry. It is our sector that in so many ways molds and orientates our world, our societies, our horizons, the horizons for us and the horizons for future generations. We need to be more progressive. We need to be more holistic, and we need to achieve solid and lasting outcomes. The focus for this needs to be in the terms of sustainability across all four pillars: the environment, human, social, as well as the financial. We need to achieve so much, we must, and together we can. Welcome to Property Guru Asia Real Estate Summit 2021.